What's up, man? You already know who it is, and you already know what it is. It's the one and only Keven Busby, and welcome back to another episode of the Gudliife movie clip slash TV show clip countdown. You feel me? And today, we're going to dedicate this episode to one of my favorite comedians, one of my favorite actors, somebody I just look up to. I'm talking about Martin Lawrence. You feel me? We're going to play some of my favorite Martin Lawrence clips from the show Martin. You feel me? Let's get into the first clip, man. Let's get it.
Now, you're all probably wondering why I called you here.
Hell yeah, you dragged us out in the middle of a stormy night. What's wrong with you, fool? And why did you want us all in black?
I'm setting my scene. Now, I have news about my CD player. Go sit your $5 ass down before I make change.
you want some $5? You make a change? $5 ass worth?
Martin, just what is your news, please?
I know who stole my CD player. And the person's in this room right now. Anybody want to tell me who? Come on now. Don't you all speak at once.
Sick. Down.
Hold it. Now, come on now. Don't anybody know nothing? Huh? Down. Yeah. I mean, come on now. Gina, Cole, Pam, Tommy. I know somebody knows something. Yeah. Ain't that right? Yeah. Sit. Lay. Yeah. Cole knows what happened, huh, Cole? Yeah. Cole knows everything. Ain't that right, Cole? Huh? You messed up, boy. You needed $400 to join your little bread sandwich union, huh? That's exactly how much my CD player cost. Ain't that right, Cole?
Martin.
Ain't that
Martin,
right?
Martin, come on, man. I mean, that was just talk, all right? Damn. You know I can't be no sandwich vendor. The man is not gonna give a brother that kind of power. Okay? It wasn't me, man. It was Pam.
Me?
Yeah, you. Think about it, Martin. She could have snuck it out of here in her weave.
Did you just say being my mom weave?
Yeah. Pam did say, and I quote, when I see something I want, I take it. Ain't that right? Ain't that right?
Martin, it was not me, okay? It was Tommy.
Wait, what about me?
Because you the one always buying them funky, fresh, fly clothes. How you be buying them, bro?
What the hell do you do for a living?
Well, nothing. You don't do nothing, Cole. Unless you call stealing from your friends a job.
See, that's enough. Okay. Why are you people asking what I do for a living? Come on, break something.
Wait a minute. Ain't gonna be no threatening us with the physical, okay? Ain't gonna be no threatening with the physical, because I can go with the big boys.
Martin, would you leave Tommy alone, please? Please. Nobody in here stole anything. Nobody in here is a thief.
That's right.
Uh-huh. 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 Yeah.
Gosh, you know what? Is that my shirt you got on?
What, this?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what happened? This what happened. I had to do laundry, right? And then I needed something to wear, so I borrowed this.
So what? You go around borrowing things without asking, Jen? Is that it? All this time, baby. Right up under here.
What's up, man? We back. That was the first clip. That was, hey, honestly, I think that's probably the best Martin episode right there. That New Jack City episode. Like, Martin, hey, look, just, I can't even get it out how funny that shit was. Just look at Tommy, the whole scene. Tommy was holding his laugh in the whole scene. Martin told Cole, Cole, sit your $5 ass down before I make change. Man, shout out to Martin, bro. And then I heard Martin wanted to, I heard he wanted a real dog, but they couldn't get the real dog, so they got a, you know, a stuffed animal. And and when he told the dog to stay and the dog dropped, he's about lay. Man, shout out to Martin, man. Let's get into the next scene of the day, man, from Martin.
Hey, Gina.
Hey, honey.
How you doing, Miss Waters? Look, I was just about to go over and talk to Marvin and Angie. You want to roll with me?
Oh, yeah, to meet Angie, most definitely.
When are we leaving?
We...
Mommy?
We could be minding our business
forever. Hey, Martin, how you doing?
How you doing, Angie?
How you doing? How you doing? Hi, I'm Gina Waters, Martin's fiancé. And this is my mother. She got my back.
Hi, Ms. Waters. Charmed.
Angie, I was just coming over to see you. I think we got a few things to talk about.
Yeah, come over here, boy. Come on.
It must be Marvin. Why don't y'all have a seat?
Marvin owes you an apology.
No, Marvin don't owe me no apology, Angie. I think you the one that owe me the apology. I mean, come on, you should have told me I had a son.
Martin!
I mean, come on. After all these years, you just gonna come around here and not even tell me I got children, people's babies? I mean, come on, you know you're lucky my mother don't drop you. You know what I'm saying?
Really, Angie, you should have told Martin he had a 10-year-old son.
First of all, Marvin is only 8 years old. And second of all, Marvin is not your son.
What?
Marvin's father is being transferred to Arizona because of his job. And see, Marvin here, he don't want to leave Detroit. And that's what that's all about.
Oh. Hold up. Hold up. You mean this ain't my son and I spent all my damn money on Shorty?
I'm sorry I lied to you, Martin. I just didn't want to go to Arizona.
I'm sorry I lied to you, Martin. I just didn't want to go to Arizona. How you gonna say I'm your hero and you lied to me? Being somebody's father is serious business, Marvin. I thought we were cool, huh? I thought we were crossing them. Bow, huh? Bow.
Go on, Marvin. Tell him why you did it.
Because I never wanted to be like Mike. I just wanted to be like Martin. Martin, can I keep my barbershop name?
Man, don't try to come at me with that little kid stuff. Martin can't keep my barbershop name. Look, I don't know, Marvin. You lost some cool points with me, man. All right. It ain't like you know, kick me in the back of the head or nothing like that. I tell you what. You go to Arizona, you know, and I check up on you there, you know, give you a chance to earn it back, you know, so to speak. We keep in touch.
Come on here, boy. We're going to go home and deal with your real father. Come on.
Marvin, look, man, you know they be tripping in Arizona, right? And no matter what they tell you, Martin Luther King's birthday is a holiday. Stay home. You ain't got no more babies I should know about out there, do you?
I'm
gone.
I'm so proud of you.
stepping up and accepting responsibility. I'd like that in a future husband.
Yeah.
Martin, we only want what's right for Gina. And I was just looking out for her best interest, but I must admit, what you did was very commendable. I really saw another side of you.
Be nice.
Yeah. And I saw another side of you, too, when I climbed in that bed with you the other night. All right, I don't want to see it no more, though, okay? I don't want to see it.
Stop.
I don't want to...
Stop.
Okay, all right, well, look, you know I'm just messing with you, little jokey joke, you little sweet mother-in-law.
Good night.
All right.
Good night, Schnookum.
Good night, Mommy.
I'm going to bed.
All right. You're going to be in there, all right? Because I don't want to get the mix-up. I got to ride.
I'm sorry I lied to you, Martin. I just didn't want to go to Arizona. Hey, shout out to Martin, man. Like, I was looking so forward to doing this episode, man, because I love Martin. You feel what I'm saying? Not just the show. I love Martin in general. Like, I'm a huge Martin Lawrence fan in general. So that was another scene, though, man, from, you know, Martin. We're going to get into the last two scenes. Let's get into the last two scenes. I would take a break after the next scene, but we're going to get into the last two scenes, and I'm going to talk to y'all after the last two scenes. So
let's... Let me think. Okay, shoot, let me think. If you really look around and look at it, we got our bed and stuff. Gina, the place is really not that bad.
What?
What's wrong?
Hey, baby.
Yeah.
I think there's a puppy in our room.
Oh, yeah.
Baby.
That ain't no damn puppy. That ain't no damn...
Get him, baby!
I think I got him. He won't be coming back no more tonight, baby.
Boy, baby. You are so brave to save me from the monster.
That's right. Gina, remember this. We got to keep this on the DL.
Yeah.
We can't let Tommy and Pam know about this, okay?
No.
At all.
No.
Okay.
No.
Now let's get our romance on.
Romance. You know.
Huh?
You fighting that monster kind of turned me on.
Mountain goat like you, Pam. Okay?
Shut up.
Now, Marty, you just have to outdo us, don't you? You know what? I'm tired of you running your mouths. Out. I want y'all out. Hobble your asses up out of here.
Right.
Get the step.
Hey, so what? When we go back home, we don't even want to see y'all.
There's a puppy behind you, man.
That ain't no damn puppy. That
That was pressure. No, no. All right.
What's up, man? We back. That was the last two clips of the day from Martin. Shout out to the whole cast of Martin, man. Shout out to Martin Lawrence, of course. Shout out to the beautiful Tashina Arnold, the beautiful Tisha Campbell. You know what I'm saying? RIP to Thomas Ford. Shout out to Carl Anthony Payne II. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody who played in Martin. You feel me? Hey, Martin had hands when he was boxing that motherfucking puppy. That's what they call it, a puppy. That ain't no damn puppy. Shout out to Martin, though, man. I wanted to do this episode, like I say, man, because I'm a huge Martin fan. I've been supporting Martin for a long time. I'm going to always support Martin. I grew up to Martin. You feel what I'm saying? So anything Martin does, I'm going to be a fan of, bro, as long as it's positive. You feel me? But shout out to Martin Lawrence, man. You already know the vibes. This was another successful episode of the Gudliife movie / TV show clip countdown, hosted by the one and only Keven Busby. And I'ma holla at y'all. I love y'all. And my bad that I was taking so long to drop another episode, but you know, he had a lot going on. You feel what I'm saying? Nothing really bad. Nothing bad. Just a lot going on. Been busy here and there. But I'm not gonna be taking breaks like that. You know what I'm saying? No more. I got to keep these shits coming for y'all, because y'all really fucking with it. You feel me? But I'm going to holler at y'all. Love y'all. Always remember what I say. Work out. Eat healthy. Pray to God. Stay positive. Stay out the way. And you will live a long, healthy lifestyle, baby. Let's get it.